the outset, I express my thanks to Dr. Mallika for conceiving this video-based course. You see, macular hole alone is easily manageable. RD, as we have seen Dr. Azad's videos, easily manageable. But once you have a combined situation, that becomes slightly tricky, still manageable. This is the usual macular surgery which all of us do. Stain nicely like Atul had shown very nice videos, and then get an edge of ILM, peel and put SF6 or sometimes air also. These are results are generally 95% very nice. All RDs nowadays, primarily we do a primary VR surgery, except in young patients, phakic eyes, dialysis, or single break, which Dr. Azad had said. Even giant tears are very nicely manageable with the routine RD surgery. The problem comes once you have a combined RD as well as a macular hole. The classic teaching has been, in fact, when we were residents, seal the peripheral break and forget about everything. That was what we used to do. But now you can't, because expectation patient is very, very high. It's a VR surgery, peel the ILM, internal tamponade. Generally works well with a flat retina and closed macular hole. But ILM peel is an issue here, because sometimes may not easily come out as in a routine macular hole surgery. So this is one of my older videos, which this patient had a traumatic giant tear. Vitreous was hazy, so did not do any OCT prior to it. In fact, after this case, I have started doing OCT virtually in all patients, because in this patient, we after starting the vitrectomy and seeing the giant tear temporally, the key issue always is to separate the vitreous, which Atul has said you may require surgical adjuncts, because it's a tight vitreous, especially in young patients and traumatic patients, which is very tightly adherent. And if you don't use tricot, sometimes you may leave behind vitreous sticking there, and which may later contribute to PVR. So this temporarily, you see this huge tear here, nearly a giant tear. So that was still manageable. We could flatten this after removing the hyoid with the help of PFCL and laser. But as soon as I saw this, we also noticed a macular hole also. So this requires additional surgery. So after doing some laser around it under the PFCL, we then injected this wonderful dye, BBG dye, and then peel. The problem here, what I noticed was, once we start peeling with the help of, say, Tano's or other instrument, the retina gets pulled. And you will see that despite taking all precautions, once you are pulling this, even with the help of forceps, you are causing some traction onto the retina. So two things I learned from this case. One was, I started doing OCT virtually in all patients of REG-RD, because I do not want to get surprised on the table that there is a macular hole also associated. So this is the ILM peel. And this patient fortunately did well anatomically. This was one of another patient had a REG-RD, peripheral breaks also there, plus a macular hole also there. So this patient settled with the surgery which I've just shown. This was another patient where we had to use silicone oil, similar surgery, ILM peel without PFCL. This was the end result. A lot of people, especially in myopic eyes, do macular buckling. I, for one, do not have any experience of putting a macular buckle, but people say functional results are reasonably good with macular buckle. And there have been various series reported where attachment occurs in virtually all the patients, and vision also improves from counting to 636. The series published by Dr. Atul Kumar in European Journal shows data of 9 patients where silicone oil has been used after ILM peel. So this is, this is one of my videos where the detachment of hyoid was very tricky. In fact, it took 90% of time detaching the hyoid. It was so sticky, this patient had the REG-RD, peripheral breaks, plus a macular hole. And it consumed virtually half of the time of surgery to peel off. We do not have ochreplasmin with us. I did use tricot to delineate the plane. Tricot has that property of getting adsorbed onto the vitreous gel, and then use this dye. This last video, This is my current technique now, which I use in all patients who has reg RD plus macular hole. So after cutting the vitreous gel, core vitrectomy, use tricot, because most important step, if there is no PVD, is to remove this adherent tricot gel. Because if you do that nicely, then I think recurrences and PVR is much less. Then I injected PFCL in this to flatten the retina and do more vitreous dissection in the base. Because after you inject PFCL, the SRF gets drained out, and you see the multiple reg component here, and then you have more access to the periphery, and you can do a lot of vitreous dissection. Then remove the PFCL, and then inject the dye under fluid only. So this we inject BBG dye, and then put PFCL again back. PFCL again back, and then try to create an edge in the ILM. This was direct pinch technique, no diamond dusted used. And here the ILM peeling becomes slightly atraumatic. And you can easily peel. The difference in the feel of surgery is that this ILM tends to get rolled rather than put a flap. So you'll see that this ILM will become a very, like a single piece. So this is what I do normally, that peel ILM under the PFCL rather than direct, because the pull onto the retina is less. And I believe the photoreceptor, you are unnecessarily pulling them too much if you do without the PFCL. The feel, as I said, is slightly different. And you can peel ILM till whatever you want. You see, once you start peeling, you really start enjoying this peeling of ILM. And take it away. And then you do usual exchange as you do in any VR surgery. This is the result of the same patient where we see this macular hole. And a couple of more patients of, this was a patient of Scleral actually, which where we use this similar technique, ILM peel. So what I believe now is, if you have a combination of peripheral tear, reg RD, macular hole, VR surgery, ILM peel under the PFCL, in my hands, gives the best kind of results. Macular buckle is an option as far as literature is concerned, but I don't use it. I do the surgery which I have described just now. Thank you very much.